हेलो, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू एवरीवन हियर। सुप्रभातम, शुभ नवरात्रि। आई एम हैप्पी एंड ग्लैड टू हैव फर्स्ट सेशन ऑन द फर्स्ट डे ऑफ नवरात्रि। थैंक यू टू राम एंड ऑल मुंबई रोड रनर्स फॉर गिविंग मी अपॉर्चुनिटी टू कंडक्ट अ सेशन ऑन योगा थेरेपी। बिफोर हेडिंग टू द सेशन, आई वुड लाइक टू गिव इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ माई सेल्फ। आई एम प्रतिष्ठिता अधिकारी, सर्टिफाइड योगा थेरेपिस्ट। आई गिव योगा थेरेपी टू डिफरेंट लाइफ स्टाइल डिसऑर्डर्स, कॉमन एलिमेंट्स एंड लाइफ स्टाइल डिसऑर्डर्स। यू मस्ट हैव अटेंडेड डिफरेंट योगा सेशंस लाइक स्टैटिक फ्लो, डायनामिक फ्लो, अष्टांग विन्यासा, ट्रेडिशनल हठ योगा एंड ऑल दैट। So you must be thinking that what is the difference between the yoga and yoga therapy? Why yoga therapy? Why not yoga? Yoga is for physical and mental overall health being and well-being. Then yoga therapy addresses, focuses more on your specific issues. That is different disorders. It is called as a yoga chikitsa. That is finding out the root cause of your problem. So here we will be taking a brief note of what all are the specific points or physical disorders, issues which you face while running or after running. So first, I will be dividing the body into two units. That is, first is the upper body and the lower body. If your upper body is firm and steady, healthy, your lower body will work finely. So we will be doing some sukshma vyayam for the upper body, and lower body will be having some stretches, some good stretches for healing purposes. If you are having some chronic back pain, or if you are having some IT glute problem, IT band problem, tight glutes or hamstrings or knee pain or ankle kind of the pain. So we will be taking care of all these things in this therapy session. I hope you will enjoy this session. You will find this session more towards the healing. I forgot to mention that I am having my venture Pratiswasthya Yoga. I am having a FB page as well, where I keep posted different wellness workshops, and I give yoga therapy. I teach yoga as well. So let's start the session. First, sit in a comfortable posture. Sitting in a very comfortable posture. I'm sitting here in Padmasana. You sit as per your comfort. Try to keep your back erect. Spine should be erect. Head should be in the center. Shoulders should be dropped down. And keep your hands in Dhyana Mudra. Index finger and thumb together, that is Dhyana Mudra. Allow some time to calm yourself. Observe your natural breath. Take a deep breath in and a long breath out. One more time, deep inhalation and long exhalation. We'll chant one Omkar here. Inhale. Feel the vibrations of Omkar throughout the body, resonance of Omkar throughout the body. Gently and slowly release the mudras. Rub your palms. Make them warm and shift them on your eyes. Slowly, hands down, touch your ears and touching each and every body part. So first we will be doing some sukshma vyayam for our shoulders. Lift your shoulders up. Lifting the shoulders up, drop them down. Lift your shoulders up, drop them down. One more time, lift your shoulders up, drop them down. Then raise both hands up all the way. Stretch your hands nicely in the upward direction. Interlock the fingers. Stretch the hands. Give a nice stretch. Warm up the body. Go slow. Take your time. Keep your head in the center. Upper arms close to the ear. Stretch the hands nicely. Rotate your wrist joints so that palms are facing towards the sky. Good, good, good. And then gently hands all the way down. Keep your left palm towards left side. Raise your right hand up and then slowly start bending laterally towards the left side. Go down as much as you can. You can keep the palm and the elbow on the ground and open up the side, right side. Good. Gently come back to the center. Keep your right palm down, right elbow down. Give some time to open up your left side. Feel a nice stretch here. Good. And then gently down. Bring your left hand behind the back. Curl your left hand behind the back. Grab your left knee and twist your body towards the left side. Look back. Good. Gently come back to the center. Bring your right hand behind the back. Grab your right knee and twist your body towards the right side. Good. And then gently release. Release and relax. Now straighten both legs. Keep your legs straight. Sit in a Dandasana, which is called as a Dandasana. Sit in your legs outstretched. Make sure both legs are straight. Whenever I give or any kind of the instruction towards body part, you focus your body part, you focus your mind on that specific body part. Keep your legs outstretched. Slowly start turning your feet sideways. Turn your feet sideways. Separate each and every toe and turning the feet towards the left side and right side. Shake your legs freely. Then tighten your thighs, lock your knees and then slowly start bringing your toes down. Bringing your toes down. Tighten your thighs, lock your knee joints, press your calf muscles to the floor and then slowly start bringing your feet down, toes down. Feel the intense stretch happening in your legs. Good. Gently bring your feet, flex toes flexing towards you, press the calf muscles against the floor, toes flexing towards you. Good, good, good and then gently release. Fold your left leg at the knee. Sit straight. Fold your left leg at the knee. Bring your left palm below the left knee. Right hand, right palm below the left foot. And then gently start shaking your leg sideways. This is for leg loosening. Sukshma Vyayam for leg loosening. This will release the tightness from your hamstrings, thighs. Start shaking like you shake your baby. Good. Gently start pressing your knee down. Press your knee down. Bring it towards the chest. Press your knee down. Bring it towards the chest. Press your knee down. Bring it towards the chest. And then gently release. Fold your right leg at the knee. Keep your right foot on the left thigh. Keep your right foot on the left thigh. Bring your right palm below the right knee. Left hand grabbing your left foot, right foot and then slowly start shaking your leg sideways. Make sure you are sitting straight. Shake it like a baby. Good. Gently fold your leg at the knee, press the knee down and then gently start bringing your knee close to the chest. Press your knee down, bring it towards the chest. Press your knee down. Bring it towards the chest and then gently release. Now keep your feet together, sitting in Baddha Konasana, Titili Asana. Keeping your feet together, again sitting straight, press your buttock bones to the floor. Aapke jo buttock bones hai, usse press karna hai niche so that your spine should be in the upright position. Bringing your knees together, join your knees together, press them down. Gentle pressing, do not apply so much force here. Again, bringing your knees together, press them down. Bringing your knees together, press them down. And then gently release and relax. Come into the standing position. Coming into the standing position, now first we will be taking the stretch with the help of the wall support, with the help of the wall. Go near the wall so that your back will be resting towards the wall. I'm pressing my back, upper back, to the wall. Keep some distance in between both the feet and then gently start bending your legs at the knees. Bend your legs at the knees. Keep your palms either on the thighs or you can interlock the fingers, stretch the hands. Press your feet actively to the floor. Keep your head in the center. Good, good. Do you feel a stretch on your legs? The stretch should not come on your knees. Good. And then gently release. Fold your left leg at the knee. Interlock the fingers. Bring your knee close to the chest. And hold there. Balance yourself. Good. Look straight. Balance. Balance. Good. Good. And then gently down. On the other side. Fold your right leg at the knee. Bring your knee close to the chest. Hold there. Balance yourself. Balance is necessary in life. Come on. Hold. Focus your gaze at one point in front of your eyes. That will give you a good balance. Good. Good. And then gently release. Now increase the distance in between both the feet. Dono pair mein thoda distance rakho. Around 3 to 4 feet distance in between both the feet. Raise both hands up all the way. Stretch both hands up all the way. Inhale and then gently start pushing your hips to the back. Stretch the arms and then slowly start bending forward. Please go slow. The body is not opened up fully. Bring your hands wherever you feel comfort. Your knees should be locked. Hold there. Keep your breathing normal. Inhale. Slowly coming up all the way. Hands are going up. Stretch the hands and then gently release. Release and relax. Now, again the therapy asana or the therapy sukshma vyayam we can say for the knee pain, chronic knee pain. One of the most important asana or the therapy sukshma vyayam is Tadasana. Raising both hands up all the way, stretch the hands and raise your heels up all the way. Come up on the tip of the toes. Haatho ko upar ki directions mein stretch karo and come up on the tip of the toes. Raise your heels up and become taller and taller. Stretch the hands. Good. 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 And then gently down. Now we will walk in Tadasana. Abhi Tadasana mein hame walk karna hai. But how you will walk? You don't have to bend the knee in order to lift the leg up. Chalte time pe hame ek leg uthana hai aur fir chalna hai. But this time we will not be bending the knee. We will be walking on the tip of the toes. Interlocking the fingers, raising both hands up. Come up on the tip of the toes and then slowly start walking in Tadasana. Dheere dheere toes ke upar chalna hai. Make sure your knees are straight. Don't bend the leg at the knee. Start stretching the hands in the upward direction. Stretch your body. This is overall stretch of the whole body. Good. Last round. Go to the back of the mat. End of the mat and then again coming to the center of the mat and then gently release. Next asana, or we can call it as the general awareness. इसमें general awareness आपका बहुत matter करता है because now I will be taking your internal awareness, bringing your internal awareness. People say, hey, I want to learn Shirshasana, I would like to stand on my head. But before standing on our head, just see yourself whether you are standing perfectly on your feet or not. Shifting your weight equally on your feet or not. Just check. Most of the times, each one of us is having a different behavior, different body parts, different structure of our body and different way of acting and using that body parts. बहुत बार लोग ऐसे ही खड़े हो जाते हैं, सो दैट होल वेट कम्स ऑन वन लेग. सो व्हाट विल हैपन, द ब्लड सर्कुलेशन विल स्टार्ट ओनली बी एक्टिवेटिंग टुवर्ड्स द राइट साइड एंड दिस लेग विल बी इनएक्टिव. सो दिस कॉजेस अननेसेसरी स्ट्रेन ऑन योर बैक एज वेल एज दिस लेग. सो व्हाइल स्टैंडिंग परफेक्टली ऑन बोथ फीट, एवरी टाइम यू हैव टू सी whether you are pressing all corners of the feet equally or not, the outer part of the foot, the front part, your toes, pressing each and every toe. So that's why separate each and every toe. Ek ek toe ko active karna hai. Press the toes actively to the floor. Press your heels actively to the floor. Lock your knees. Keep your legs straight. Lock your knees. Then suck the abdomen in. Chest should be expanded. Roll the shoulders back and bring your hands by the sides of your body and look straight. Keep your head in the center. This is actually the proper standing asana or the proper standing position in yoga. Just check whether you are pressing both feet equally or not, whether your weight has been distributed equally on both feet or not. Adjust your weight, press the heels, press your toes. Good. Observe your breathing, what happens when the chest is getting expanded. Good. Stretch the fingers, feel them active, and then gently release. So before heading any of the standing asanas, you stand firmly on the in Tadasana. Now we will be practicing a very important therapy asana, which is called as the Ardhakati Chakrasana, which is a part of cyclic meditation. So, while practicing the yoga therapy or while taking the yoga therapy, one should practice the asanas as a meditative aspect. When you practice the asanas in a very slow and the meditative aspect, you get healed very quickly or easily because your mind is connected to your body. So, let's start for Ardhakati Chakrasana. Again, standing firmly on both feet. This time, I'm keeping my feet together. My knees are locked. My ankles are active. I'm separating each and every toe to the floor and pressing them actively to the floor. Then bringing the hands by the sides of the body. Now look straight. Now you will be raising your right hand up. Go according to my instructions. Just sharpen your ears, sharpen your hearing sense and look straight. Slowly start raising your right hand up. धीरे धीरे right hand को straight रखना है और धीरे धीरे right hand को start stretching or lifting the hand up, increasing each and every angle by 10 degree. 20, 30, 40, like that. Make sure all fingers are together. You are completely aware of your body part. As if the hand is just moving by its own, you are not taking any efforts for lifting the hand up. Bring your hand at 90 degree. Bring your hand at 90 degree, that is in line with your shoulder. Now at shoulder joint, make sure your shoulder, your elbow joint, your wrist joint, everything is in one line. Bring your internal awareness to find out the alignment of the arm. Good. Gently turn the palm upward. Straighten the arm more and more. Pointed awareness. Slowly start raising your hand up more and more. Raising your hand up, increasing the angle again by 10 degree. Lifting the hand up. 100, 120, 130, 140, going all the way in the upward direction. Feel the nice opening up of your right hand and stay there. Hold the position. When the hand reaches, the arm reaches at 180 degree. Straighten the arm here. Good. Straighten the arm here more and more. Let the upper arm be close to the ear. Biceps touching to the ear, surface awareness, and then gently start bending laterally towards the left side. Go slow. Take your time. Good. The left palm will slide down towards the left knee. धीरे धीरे फील द नाइस स्टिमुलेशन ऑन द राइट साइड. ईच एंड एवरी नर्व इज गेटिंग अ ब्यूटिफुल स्टिमुलेशन. गुड. जेंटली एंड स्लोली स्टार्ट ब्रिंगिंग योर हैंड बैक टू 180 डिग्री. फील ऑल द ब्लड गशिंग डाउन टुवर्ड्स द हार्ट. Slowly start bringing your hand back to 90 degree. Again going slow. Please take your time. No hurry. Bring your hand at 90 degree. Straighten the arm there. Gently start turning the palm down. And then slowly start bringing the arm down. Lowering down the angle. धीरे 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 हाथ को बेसिक पोजिशन में सेंटर पोजिशन में लेकर आना है. एंड नाउ फील द चेंजेस इन बिटवीन योर लेफ्ट हैंड एंड द राइट हैंड. ऑब्जर्व द चेंजेस टुवर्ड्स द लेफ्ट साइड एंड द राइट साइड. नाउ ब्रिंग योर हैंड लेफ्ट हैंड towards the upward direction. Gently start lifting your hand up. Go slow. Take your time. Bring your left hand up, increasing the angle by 10 degree. Good. Straighten the arm there. Once you reach it at 90 degree, straighten the arm more and more. Turn the palm upward direction. Feel a nice stretch at the shoulder joint, elbow joint and the wrist joint. Gently start bringing your hand up. Again increasing the angle. Good. Good. Feel all the nerves are getting a beautiful stimulation. Bring your hand at 180 degree. Straighten the arm at 180 degree. The head should not go towards the hand. The hand should come towards the head. Feel the nice opening and stretching. Gently start bending laterally towards the right side. Go slow. Take your time. Upper arm close to the ear. One side of the abdomen is getting contracted. Other side is getting a beautiful stretch. Your waist muscles are also getting a beautiful stimulation. Start bringing your right palm towards the right knee. Good. And then gently start bringing your hand back to 180 degree. Straighten the arm there. Observe the changes in blood circulation. You will feel that the hand has become very heavy. You will be tempting to bring the hand down immediately, but don't do that. Slowly start bringing your hand to 90 degree from 180 degree and touching each and every angle, bringing the hand at 90 degree. Feel the heaviness in the hand. Turn the palm down and then gently and slowly start bringing the hand down. Observe the changes in between the left side and right side. This is all about the internal awareness. What are the changes happening when you do a pose or when you do a movement in a very static, in a very slow manner? This is your mind test as well, patient's test as well. This was like Ardha Kati Chakrasana, which is a good therapy asana for your back, your arm, your upper back and the lower legs as well. Now, we will be going for the therapy asana for the back pain, chronic back pain. So, lie down on your mat. Lying down in supine position. Lying down on your back in supine position. Keep your arms in line with your shoulders. Fold your legs at the knees. बहुत बार क्या होता है कि back pain होने की वजह से you are not able to keep the legs straight. So in that case, you will be folding your legs at the knees. Keep your arms in line with your shoulders. Head will be in the center. Now, slowly start raising your right leg up and try to keep right leg on top of the left leg. Both thighs are together. I'm bringing my right leg on top of the left leg. Tight rakhna hai thighs ko. Then, Slowly start lifting your left leg up and try to hook your right foot below the calf muscle of the left leg. If you are not able to hook the foot, it's okay. You keep the feet like this, just keeping the leg on top of the left leg. If you are comfortable hooking the foot, hook your foot. This is called as the Garudasana stretch, Supta Garudasana. Now, from here, slowly start turning your knees towards the left side. Dheere dheere chala hai. Start bringing the knees towards the left side. Go slow. Take your time. Start pushing the palms to the floor. You look straight or you can close your eyes and observe the changes happening to the lower back. Few breaths there, normal breathing. Gently and slowly bring your legs back to the center. Now turning your knees and turning your legs towards the right side. Slowly start bringing your knees towards the right side. Start pressing the palms to the floor. Feel the nice opening at the back region. Beautiful stretch comes on your back. Complete internal awareness. When you are practicing therapy, your mind should be completely alert, active. Good. And then gently and slowly bringing your legs back to the center. Slowly release the upper leg, coming back to the same position. Now we will be practicing it on the other side. Raise your left leg up, keep it on the top of the right leg. My both thighs are tight and being with each other. Now slowly start lifting your right leg up. Bring the foot below the calf muscle. You practice slow as per your comfort, as per your comfort level as well. Slowly start pushing the palms to the floor and then gently start bringing your knees towards the right side. Go slow. Take your time. Turn your foot. Press the palms to the floor. The arms should be resting on the floor. Arms should not lift up. That's why I'm saying push the palms to the floor. Or phir dheere dheere knees will turn towards the right side. Any kind of the lower back pain or your sacrum region is having some discomfort will get released. If you practice this Supta Garudasana stretch, gently bring your knees back to the center. Slowly start turning your knees towards the left side. Dheere dheere with awareness, no jerky movement. Try to listen to your body parts. Good. Normal breaths there. Observe the changes. Slowly and then gently bring your knees back to the center and then slowly release your legs. Observe what are the changes happening in the body. After long runs, you may feel some lower back pain. So you can practice this at home on mat. Now the another stretch is cross leg Pavan Muktasana. Cross leg Pavan Muktasana. So again folding both legs at the knees. Keep some hip width distance in between both the feet. Bring your right leg up. Right foot on the left thigh. Fold your right leg at the knee. Bring your right foot on the left thigh. Lift your left leg up. Interlocking the fingers and grabbing your thigh. Left hand is outside, right hand is going from inside. Bringing the palms or interlocking the fingers, you slowly start bending your elbows and then gently start bringing your knee towards the head. Exhaling, gently going down. Do not loosen the hands. Keep your hands and the leg in the same position. Now we will be doing it with breathing. Whenever you practice any of the therapy asana with breathing, the healing efficiency increases. So inhale here, take a deep breath. Slowly start bringing your head towards the knee. Good. Complete squeezing of all the middle body parts. Inhale. Exhaling, slowly start bringing your head down and then gently release your hands, release your leg. Slowly release your right leg. We will be repeating it on the other side, balancing both sides. Hold your left leg at the knee, keep the left foot on the right thigh. Left hand will go from inside within the folded legs. The right hand will be going outside, interlock the fingers and then slowly start lifting your head up. Press the back to the floor, press the back to the floor, reach wherever you can. Don't stretch your neck muscles here. Good, good. And then gently and slowly bring your head down. Do not loosen the hands, do not loosen the position. We will be doing it with breathing. Inhale, take a deep breath. Slowly start bringing your head towards the knee. Exhaling, gently head down and then slowly release your legs. This is called as the cross leg Pavan Muktasana. And then gently release and relax. Bring your awareness on the lower back, whether you feel any changes. Slowly and gently turn your body to one side, take the support of elbow and come into the sitting position. Coming into the sitting position. Sitting in Vajrasana. Both legs are folded and you are sitting in Vajrasana. Another therapy asana for your legs. Now, you bring your palms on both sides of the abdomen. Dono palms ko fingers open karo. Bring both palms on both sides of the abdomen. Let your chest gets expanded here. Elbows are going back, moving back. Throw your head back. Exhale. Slowly start bending forward. Dheere dheere. Aram aram se. Let your abdomen go down first, then your chest will go down and then gently your head will go down. People always hurry to bring your head down. So this time we will be going in a systematic manner. Reach wherever you can. It doesn't matter if the head is touching to the floor or not. Reach wherever you can. While coming up, inhale. Take a deep breath. Slowly head up first. Then chest up, then abdomen up and then gently body will come up. So here the squeezing of all the middle body parts happen. You get a massaging effect to all the internal organs, that is your stomach, your pancreas, your liver and lower abdomen, upper abdomen. At the same time you get a beautiful stretch on your back. This needs a lot of internal awareness and connection. So this time we will be doing this with breathing. Breathing ke saath mein karna hai and make sure you close your eyes. Eyes closed, roll the shoulders back, elbows will go back. Widen your chest while we are expanding the chest to keep your breathing in a normal condition. Inhale, take a deep breath. Fill your lungs with the air. Exhaling, slowly start bending forward. How you will bend? Bring your abdomen down, then bring your chest down and then gently start bringing your head down. Reach wherever you can. Reach wherever you can. Don't force your body too much. Once you come into the final position, drop your shoulders, relax your elbows. The buttocks should not lift off the heels. Good. While coming up, inhale, take a deep breath, head up first, then chest up, then abdomen up and then gently coming up. Now I will be showing you from the side view, because most of the times the common wrong positions are happening in Sashankasana breathing is like you lift your buttocks up and then you bring your head down. Here I would like to emphasize more that you try to keep your buttocks as much as touching to the heels. Doesn't matter whether the head is going down or not. Bahut baar kya hota hai ki belly fat bahut zyada rehta hai, so you are not able to go down. So we will be doing some correction or some adjustment. Therapy is all about doing the adjustment according to your body comfort. It's not like a structured module according to your body comfort and limitations. So in that case, the people who are not able to go down, make sure your knees are in a V position. Keep some distance in between both the knees. That's completely fine. Bring your palms by the sides of the abdomen. फिर palms को भी ऐसे रखना है so that you will be pressing. You are giving self massage. So pressing the palms to the floor, widening the chest part, bringing the elbows back, throw your head back, inhale here, exhaling, slowly start bending forward. See how I am bending? First my abdomen is going down, then chest is going down, and then gently start bringing your head down. If you feel discomfort over here, you can keep the palms here and then bring your head down. That's also fine. Normal breathing. Once you bring your head down, this controls your blood pressure, regulates the high and the low blood pressure. While coming up, inhale, take a deep breath, and then slowly coming up, and then gently coming up. So this was all about for relaxing, rejuvenating and re-energizing asana for your back, your legs, and controls your breathing as well. इट काम्स डाउन योर माइंड. बहुत बार बहुत हाइपर एक्टिविटी करने के बाद में यू नीड दैट माइंड टू काम डाउन. व्हेनेवर द माइंड इज इन अ डल पोजिशन, यू हैव टू अवेकन इट बाय डूइंग सम रजस्टिक एक्टिविटी. उसको थोड़ा सा प्रोत्साहित करना है. बट वंस द माइंड हैज कम्प्लीटली इन टू द एक्टिव मोड, द योगा सेज दैट यू हैव टू क्वाइटन दैट माइंड. दैट इज योर ट्रू नेचर. ओके, the last sitting asana over here is a malasana, which is again good for every runner. There are number of asanas for the special yoga therapy for runners, and due to the time limitation we cannot cover all the things, but some few basic asanas which you can do at your home without any observation or supervision, I'm just demonstrating that one. But always practice as per your comfort. सिटिंग इन मालासन, स्क्वाट में बैठना है. कीपिंग योर फीट एक्टिवली टू द फ्लोर, फीट को एक्टिवली रखो. बहुत बार आई हैव सीन अ लॉट ऑफ गुड रनर्स विच आर नॉट एबल टू सिट फर्मली ऑन देयर फीट. फीट पे बैठ ही नहीं पाते हैं बिकॉज ऑफ द टाइट ग्लूट्स और बिकॉज ऑफ देयर हिप स्ट्रक्चर एंड ऑल दैट. दे आर नॉट एबल टू सिट प्रॉपरली ऑन देयर हिप्स. तो उनके लिए ये एक एडजस्टमेंट है. यू कैन कीप द पाम्स डाउन एंड कमिंग अप ऑन द टोज, बट आइडियली दिस इज द मालासन्स पोजिशन वेयर यू आर प्रेसिंग द फीट एक्टिवली टू द फ्लोर. नाउ आई एम ओपनिंग अप द नीज विद द हेल्प ऑफ माई एल्बोज, ज्वाइनिंग द पाम्स इन नमस्कार पोजिशन. आपको पूरे फिंगर्स प्रेस करना है सो दैट यू विल गेट द बेनिफिट ऑफ प्रेसिंग द पाम्स एंड फिंगर्स एक्टिवली टू द ईच अदर. ओपन अप द नीज एंड स्टार्ट एक्सटेंडिंग योर स्पाइन इन द अपवर्ड डायरेक्शन. नीचे झुकना नहीं है. दिस इज अगेन अ कंफर्ट पोजिशन. सो यू हैव टू एक्सटेंड एंड लेंथन द स्पाइन इन द अपवर्ड डायरेक्शन एंड नाउ यू विल रियलाइज दैट यू आर गेटिंग अ स्ट्रेच ऑन योर एंकल जॉइंट. गुड गुड. Start pressing the palms. Bring your palms closer to the chest. Lift your chin up. Look straight. Observe the internal awareness. What are the changes happening on my feet, on my ankles, on my calves, on my knees, hips, pelvic girdle gets open here. So this is actually the mood rejuvenating or mood refreshing asana. अगर आपको थोड़ा low energy लग रहा है, you feel some anxious thoughts in your mind, you start practicing this malasana and see the benefit. Okay, good. A slightly extended therapy asana to this is woodcutter's pose. Woodcutter kaise karta hai? Interlocking the fingers. Hame abhi wood kaatna hai. Inhale, raise both hands up, and while exhaling you will make the sound like ha. Inhale. Inhale and then gently release. Again sitting in malasana. Good. Slowly come into the standing position. So this was all about the opening up of your lower body parts or healing of your lower body parts. Today is the first day of Navratri and we will be practicing the goddess pose. Simple goddess pose, which is again good for your lower body parts, which strengthens your knees, which strengthens your legs. So get ready, invoke a goddess feminine energy within you. Every individual is a combination of masculine and the feminine energies. So today we will be invoking the feminine energy within us, yin and yang, Shiva and Shakti. So feet will be slightly outside, left foot facing towards left side, right foot facing towards the right side. As you go down, slowly start bending your both knees. Bend both legs at the knees. धीरे से अच्छे से bend करो. How to check the alignment, whether you are in a proper posture or not, your knees should come in line with your ankles. Knee should not cross the ankle and it should not go up as well. So, sitting down in goddess pose, bring the shoulders back, roll the shoulders back and bring your hands here. Invoke a goddess. Have a smile or you can bring your tongue outside. Kali. Good. 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 And then gently release. Release and relax. Sit in a comfortable posture. We will be talking about the breathing. We will be taking some breathing exercises. Because as you progress in your running, on the road running or in marathon, you realize that your body has become so much flexible and you have all the strength within your body, but your breathing is not cooperating to you. After a particular run or like after a few kilometers, you feel start gasping. So we will be working on breathing here. Again, sit in a comfortable posture. Here I am sitting in Padmasana. You sit as per your comfort. A simple cross-leg position is also fine. Sukhasana. The only condition while practicing pranayama or breathing, that is, spine should be erect all the time, because when you keep your spine erect, your brain becomes alert. And in yoga we say that the spiritual energy flows when you start keeping your spine in the center position. If you are having back pain, you take the support of wall. It's absolutely fine to take the support of the wall, go near the wall. So first breathing practice, before going for breathing practice, just let's check whether your nostrils are opened or not, both the nostrils, you are breathing through both the nostrils or not. How to check? Take your right hand index finger and bring it below the left nostril. Check whether the air is coming in or going out below your right nostril. Throughout the day, we are only breathing, inhaling and exhaling through one nostril, or most of the times it gets reset. After 3 hours, it reset, that is left to right, right to left. At the time of sunrise, sunset or 12 o'clock, there are very rare times when you are breathing through both the nostrils. But in yogic science, we say that we have the switches within ourselves. We have the switches with us and we can keep it on. Agar ek nostril partially open hai, toh we can keep it on. Okay? So first we will be practicing Shvasana Shuddhi. My left nostril is fairly open, but right nostril is not that much open. So we will be practicing for opening up of both the nostrils. That is called as the Shvasana Shuddhi, clearing the nasal passage. Keeping your left hand in Dhyana Mudra. Again, index finger and thumb together. This is the mudra of concentration, knowledge, and we are locking the energy because we are playing with the pranic energy. Making the fist of your right hand. Make the fist of your right hand, thumb pointing up. Closing your right nostril gently. Right nostril ko halke se dabana hai. Don't give too much pressure to the right nostril. Yahan pe ek bone hai. This is called as a nose bone. Nose bone ke niche ek point hai. Just you have to press that point and close your right nostril gently. And then start exhaling through the left. Aapko sirf exhalation karna hai, inhalation will happen automatically. Complete exhalation and then stop the practice. So this is also called as the half Kapalbhati, nostril opening. We'll be doing it with the other side. Right hand in Dhyana Mudra. Make the fist of your left hand. closing your left nostril gently and start exhaling through the right. And then gently release and relax. And now check with the index finger. Actually, we have taken very slow or low strokes, but just check whether any change is happening. If you do it for 30 to 40 times, you will realize that the nostril has get open. Okay. After this, we are ready for practicing the pranayama. The very first or the important breathing pranayama for runners is a square breathing. What happens in square breathing? I am inhaling, I am exhaling. But in between, you have to add the kumbhakas, that is holding the breath, which is called as a retention of the breath. So what I will be doing, I will be inhaling deep, engage your all the respiratory organs, your abdomen, your chest, your clavicular region, your walls of the nostrils, everything will come into the picture. Inhale deep, you hold the breath inside, that is called as the antar kumbhaka, holding the breath inside. And check your, as per your lung capacity. I'm not giving any count or time duration for how long you can hold the breath inside. You hold the breath inside as per your lung capacity. Then exhale fully, long exhalation, full exhalation. And then again hold the breath outside. That is called as the outer, Bahya Kumbhaka. It means you are inhaling, which is called as the Pura. Holding the breath inside, that is called as the Antar Kumbha. And then exhaling, which is called as the Recha. And again, you are applying the Bandha or you are holding the breath outside, which is called as the Bahya Kumbha. Okay, so Pura, Antar Kumbha, holding the breath inside, then exhaling long, Recha, and then Bahya Kumbha. Inhaling, hold the breath inside, exhale, hold the breath outside. So every time you have to check how long you can hold the breath inside and how long you can hold the breath outside. This improves your lung capacity, which works on opening up of your respiratory lobes, and efficiency of your respiratory lobes increases. Okay, going as per your comfort, find your comfort level every time. Internal awareness, mindfulness in your practice. Sit straight, hands in Dhyana Mudra. We are locking the energy. Natural breath. Just observe each incoming and outgoing breath. Now we will be starting the square breathing pranayama. Take a deep inhalation. Hold the breath inside, Antar Kumbhaka. Exhale fully, Recha. Hold the breath outside, Bahya Kumbha. Inhale, Pura. Hold the breath inside, Antar Kumbha. Exhale fully, reach up, hold the breath outside, do not inhale. Again inhale, pour up, hold the breath inside as per your lung capacity. Exhale fully. Reach up, hold the breath outside, do not inhale. Inhale, pour up, hold the breath inside, do not be in a hurry for exhalation. Exhale fully, hold the breath outside, do not inhale. So in that way, we are completing the square. Inhale, holding the breath, exhale, holding the breath, inhale, holding the breath, exhale, holding the breath. Last round, inhale, pull up, hold the breath inside. Exhale fully, hold the breath outside. Do not inhale and then gently normal breathing. So this was all about the square breathing, holding the breath, retention of the breath, which is the actual purpose of pranayama. Pranayama, prana ko extend karna hai. Aapki jo pranic shakti hai, vital force hai, living force hai, that you have to extend. That is called as the pranayama. Okay, so we'll be having too much serious session. I think we will be having one fun which is called as the Sinha Garjana. सिंह गर्जना में आपको रोरिंग करना है लायन के जैसा. एंड लेट मी नो और लेट मी सी हु इज रोरिंग वेरी लाउडली एट योर होम, वेदर द लायनेस और लायन. सो यू हैव टू सिट इन वज्रासन और वीरासन टाइप ऑफ पोजिशन वेयर योर नीज आर स्लाइटली असाइड. आप वज्रासन में कंफर्टेबल है तो यू सिट इन वज्रासन एंड कीप योर हैंड्स इन फ्रंट ऑफ योर बॉडी. सो यू विल बी मेकिंग अ वी शेप ऑफ योर नीज. Keep the palms turning, fingers turning inward, और फिर palms को अंदर रखना है knees के, so that you will make a V shape of your knees. अगर वीरासन में comfortable है, वीरासन it means your feet are also aside and your knees are also aside and your buttocks are resting in between both the legs. Okay? So इसमें क्या करना है कि आपको दहाड़ना है, roaring करना है lion के जैसा. ऐसे कहते हैं कि लायन जब रोअर करता है तो 8 किलोमीटर तक उसकी दहाड़ सुनाई देती है. सो लेट मी सी कौन सा लायन और कौन सी लायनेस बहुत ज्यादा दहाड़ती है. हु इज हैविंग अ मोर स्ट्रेंथ पावरफुल थिंग फॉर रोअरिंग. थोड़ा फनी है, डोंट लाफ एट माय टंग और डोंट लाफ एट माय पोजीशन. जब मैं टंग पूरा निकालूंगी तो आई विल मेक अ साउंड लाइक रोअरिंग साउंड ऑफ द लायन. Which is also a good therapy asan for any kind of the like depression, or you are having some suppressed emotions, you are mentally very low, because most of the times we are not able to express our emotions clearly. This is the case with most of the male. बहुत बार यहाँ तक टंग तक आते हैं सब ख्याल या शब्द आते हैं, but we are not bringing it out. So in Sinha Garjana, we will be throwing all these things out and like purifying the body. Okay, so all the pent up emotions from our heart will get opened up and we will be more relaxed, more happy, more stress free. Okay, so let's get ready. Palms को अंदर रखना है, fingers are inside. थोड़ा सा आपको lean करना है. You will be leaning your body forward. फिर I'm just bending my elbows. धीरे से बेंड करने हैं, नॉट टू मच, सो दैट माय चेस्ट इज रेस्टिंग ऑन माय अपर आर्म्स. ओके, सो यू विल बी इनहेलिंग हियर, एक्सहेलिंग, ब्रिंगिंग द टंग आउट फुल्ली. इट्स फनी है, राइट, बट इट्स क्वाइट इफेक्टिव. चलो टू मोर टाइम्स, इनहेल, लास्ट राउंड और थोड़ा लाउडली सो दैट नेबर्स विल ऑल्सो वेक अप. कम ऑन, एंड देन जेंटली रिलीज, रिलीज एंड रिलैक्स. सो दिस इज अ गुड थेरेपी फॉर थायराइड एंड पैराथायराइड डिफिशियंसी एज वेल, एनी काइंड ऑफ द इम्बैलेंस इन द थायराइड रीजन, और फिर मूड रिलैक्सिंग लूजनिंग के लिए बहुत अच्छा है. सो दिस वाज ऑल अबाउट अ शॉर्ट डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ व्हाट योगा थेरेपी इज, गोइंग इन अ वेरी स्लो. एक्चुअल बाय गिविंग द थेरेपी आई गो वेरी स्लो एज पर द इंडिविजुअल थिंग्स. एंड व्हाट हैपेंस इन योगा थेरेपी, दैट इन थेरेपी वी वर्क ऑन अ इंटीग्रेटेड अप्रोच ऑफ योगा. That is when I say that I am Pratishruta, I'm existing. You are seeing my physical body itself, but I am existed in pranamaya kosha. That is, pranic energy is flowing within me. Then I am having a mind. It means I am present in the manomaya kosha. That is my mind. And then I am living with my intellect as well. I am having my buddhi. So vijnanamaya kosha. And I am having a last layer of my existence, which is called as the anandamaya kosha, which is a complete existence of pure bliss, and which is our true nature. Human being's true nature is being happy without any reason. Okay, so this is all about the integrated approach of yoga therapy. We heal the yoga therapy according to scanning your overall personality and what kind of the back, why the problem is there, how long the problem is there, and what is the root cause of that problem. Sometimes the back pain is not due to the structural defect. Sometimes it is due to the overstress. You are pushing yourself too hard beyond your capacities. So this is internal realization, self-realization, and acting in that way. Okay. So visit my page Pratiswasthya Yoga on Facebook. I would like to connect you for any kind of the help assistance. I thank you, Ram, and all the Mumbai Roadrunners for giving me this opportunity to spread the word of yoga therapy. You must have heard about the physiotherapy, but yoga therapy is a very, a very rare thing, or I don't know how much of you have taken the yoga therapy for a specific ailment or common ailment. Okay, so we will be concluding the session with one Omkar and the final prayer. Sit in a comfortable posture. Eyes closed. Just sit, relax. Complete silence within you. We'll be chanting one Omkar. Inhale. Join your palms in Namaskar position. We will be chanting the final prayer for universal peace. Asato Ma Sakamayo. Om Asato Ma Sakamayo. Tamaso Ma Jyotirgamayo. Mrityur Ma Amrutam Gamayo. Loka Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu. Loka Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu. Naham Karta Hari Hi Karta. Hari Hi Karta Hi Kevalam. Shanti Mantra 3 times. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Let all be happy. Let all be disease free. Slowly start rubbing your palms. Make them warm. Shift that energy on your eyes. Gently on your ears. Neck muscles. Touch each and every body part. Self touch, self healing. Feel the vibrations when you touch your own body parts. Then gently hands up. Raise your hands up. Stretch the hands in the upward direction. Turn your body towards the left side, post stretch, center, right side, center, hands down, join your palms in Namaskar position, Parvatasana, Sharanagat Mudra, surrendering pose, surrendering to the Mother Earth, nature, get the positivity for the whole day, hands up, and try to come into the standing position without taking the support or with taking the minimum support. Gently, a final stretch, happy stretch, Tadasana stretch. Raise your heels up, hands up. Good. Smile on your face. Good. Gently, hands down. Hari Om. Thank you for joining the session. I hope you enjoyed the session. Let me know how you feel. Okay, chalo. Bye-bye. Have a nice day. Shubha Navratri.